Hey everyone, this is Derek here, and in this video we're going to be taking a look at the initial setup as well as the features of Tencent's new official beta emulator for PUBG Mobile called Tencent Gaming Buddy. So if you don't have this emulator installed on your system, definitely check out my earlier video for how to download it, and I'll leave a link to that video in the description below. And as I was explaining in that video, the reason Tencent, the developers of PUBG Mobile, are also developing an emulator for it is because they want to control the issue where emulators are being matched up right now against mobile gamers. And it's not fair to those of you on iPhones and, you know, Galaxies and tablets to be matched up against someone on a mouse and a keyboard, because they have a lot more control and a lot more precision. So their solution is to come up with their own emulator, which will hopefully be the best emulator. That way everyone will want to use this one, and they'll be matched up against other people playing on the emulators instead of mobile phone users who might not stand as much of a chance. So this video, like I said, is assuming that you have it installed. After it installs the base emulator, it downloads and installs PUBG Mobile. So we'll go ahead and click on play here, and we'll see what this emulator is all about. And obviously this is in beta, so some features may change, but today is May 3rd, and we're going to take a look at how it works right now, which is a couple days after it was initially released. So you can see here it's starting to load, and we'll start here with the controller. So I'm going to narrate this video like you, I'm going to assume that you might not have experience with emulators. So I'm going to tell you what all these keys do and what they are and why we care about them. So obviously with an emulator, we don't have a touch screen to tap on like a smartphone, but we have a mouse and a keyboard, which are even more powerful. So WASD are your directional keys. These move you forward, back, left, and right. Left click, these are all defaults, by the way. Left click is to fire your weapon or punch or use your melee weapon. Right click is to aim or aim down scope, is how you might hear it referred to. The space bar is to jump or vault or swim up. C and Z are crouch and prone. So by default, C is crouch, Z is prone. We'll just go ahead and mute that. That way you don't have to listen to music over me. Free look is by holding down the Alt key, which is next to spacebar on most keyboards. You're able to look around using your mouse without losing the direction that you're aiming and currently moving in. This is very useful for looking for people around you, as used very often. Shift is sprint or run faster. And then you have your quick keys for your throwables, so your frags, your smoke grenades, your Molotovs, or your stun grenades, either or. Those are your 4, 5, and 6. 7, 8, 9, and 0 are your healing quick keys, so med kit, first aid kit, bandage, and painkiller slash energy drink slash syringe. And then F1 is your key reminder switch. I believe if you tap this, it just tells you what key does what in the game. Mouse lock switch is to lock auto run, so basically you'll just keep running straight until you click it again, or you click the WASD keys, I think cancel cruise control too, kind of. And then F does everything else. So F opens doors, it gets you into vehicles, it picks up items, to parachute, it pretty much does everything else, as you'll see. And then display here, resolution HD 1080p. Let's go into the settings real quick and take a look at that. So you've got three default resolutions. You've got SD, HD, and Ultra HD. SD should be for devices that don't have a dedicated graphics card, or devices that are more than a few years old, because the game, even though it's a mobile game, is pretty intense to emulate, so it does use quite a few system resources. HD, what I'm on right now, is for fairly recent computers with a 660 or higher, so I'd say like gaming desktops that are more, less than 4 years old, or laptops that are less than 3 years old, maybe. But it depends on what you have, obviously. And then Ultra HD 2K is for top computers with a 1060 or higher, so a very new graphics card, only a year or two old. I'm playing on a laptop that has a 7700 HQ i7 and a 1060 graphics card, so a fairly decent performance laptop. But I'm going to run on HD 1080 for now, just because I'm also screen capturing, so I don't know how those are going to work together. Display quality we'll leave at auto. So it auto selects smooth, balanced, and HD, or low, medium, and high, basically. Presets for your textures and other stuff in game. We'll take a look here at basics. Run at startup. I unchecked that because I don't want this starting up when I start up the computer. Boss key, I have no clue what this is. Unfortunately, this emulator didn't come with an instruction manual or a user guide in English, I don't think. So if you know what this is, leave it in the comments below, because it sounds cool, but I don't think there are bosses in PUBG Mobile, so I don't know what it does. And then screen capture is where you're capturing your screenshots to, because this has a built-in screen recorder that I'll show you later, and language is self-explanatory. Engine, this is your video rendering engine. I'm just leaving it in smart mode, which I believe defaults to DirectX Plus on this machine. I'm leaving these enabled, and I enabled prioritized dedicated GPU just because this laptop does have a dedicated graphics card, the 1060, as well as the internal graphics card built into the i7. So, in order to, because this is a Optimus enabled laptop, so I click that button just to do that. Anti-aliasing, probably going to leave it off just because I'm screen capturing, but you have balanced and ultimate as options. Memory, I'm leaving auto. I believe this is how much system memory it uses, not how much video memory it uses. Processor, I'm leaving it auto too. This is a quad core, but it should do that automatically. Resolution is what resolution the game is being rendered in. And then DPI, my understanding is this is your scaling factor. So we'll just go ahead and, I think that's everything there. So we'll go ahead and click save and see what else we've got. So next up, we'll talk about key mapping. And this is your key mapping. So basically this is everything that, so because you don't have a touchscreen most likely on your device that you're emulating on, you instead have to rely on the keyboard, which is even more powerful. And these are the keys that it tells you what to do. So 1 and 2 are your primary and secondary weapons. So because this is a mobile game, what this interface, this emulator is actually doing is it's virtually pushing on the screen. You know, this is kind of how the game interprets it, is it's pushing on the screen where those virtual buttons would be. So when you press spacebar to a jump, for example, that means that this button here is jump. You know, when you press on the left mouse button to fire, this is the fire button, you know, on your mobile version, on your phone. This is your virtual joystick. It's replaced by, so that's how this works. Key mapping mode, we'll just leave it in normal right now. We got smart, different resolutions. So we'll take a look at this in another video just because I don't want this to go on forever. I am not 100% sure what steering wheel means. I believe it's just placing a directional pad where the virtual joystick usually goes. Aiming makes a lot more sense to me. This is, you actually, so you right click to lock your ADS. So basically you right click and you stay aim down until you right click again. Otherwise you have to hold right click while you want to aim. And then as soon as you release the right click mouse button, you'll go back to your normal view. And then firing, I'm not entirely sure why you would disable that. I don't know if that just disables the button or if it disables firing. That one doesn't make too much sense to me either. Secondary display key mapping tips, F1. So like I said, the F1 displays what everything is, what it does. So if you know it by heart and you don't have to, you know, see, as you'll see in the game, if you have to loot a certain weapon or something, you might have to press FG or H if there are multiple options for grabbing items. So this allows you to enable or disable that. So once you know it by heart, you don't have to clutter the screen with that. And then gamepad, we're going to try this with a Bluetooth game controller. I have an Xbox One controller that's Bluetooth that will link to this computer. And we'll try that in another video and see if that works, because that would be pretty fun. So you've got some auto switch mode based on scene, brightness. So we're just going to leave that default, honestly. I'll just go here. We'll save, sure, why not? And that's that. Shakes the screen. I don't know if it does any more than that. I don't really know what the significance of that is. Someone can leave that below too. Full screen just stretches this to full screen. Multi-window allows you to run multiple instances of the emulator at the same time. This is useful if you have, for example, multiple monitors. And for video creators like me, I've used two phones recording, you know, with a tripod over them a couple times to demonstrate various things, like the stun grenade video, where I showed that if you're holding a stun grenade and you hold it until it blows up, you actually don't blind yourself. You only blind people around you. So I used a second phone to show that that is indeed the case. So it's useful if you're creating content like we are to have that option to run multiple instances, although I'd imagine it's going to require a pretty powerful machine to do that smoothly. Screenshots. This will take a screenshot of the current screen and will save it in the folder that you specified earlier. As we saw, video recording. This has built-in video recording. I'll let you know how smooth it is once I try it out. But it's pretty cool that the emulator has that built in. And then virtual location. Not entirely sure if this is some sort of a proxy, or I don't know what that is either. I've clicked on it and it doesn't really do anything. It just takes you back to that. So maybe that is to just exit out of the screen. Maybe that virtual location, maybe that's like an exit button. It looks kind of like a going through a door. So perhaps, like I said, there is no instruction manual or user guide in English right now. I don't think there is, or I don't have it at least. So a few of these we have to kind of guess on, but pretty good understanding overall. Rotate is if you want to rotate your screen. And let's see here, what else is there? There's volume. This is just your virtual game volume, emulating your hardware buttons on a phone. Clean cache. Cleans your cache, so if you have certain texturing issues and stuff, you could try that. Repair SD, that's another tool to try if you're having problems with the emulator, if it's not running well. Show FPS, you can see I'm running at 25 FPS. I don't really know how good or bad that is, but that's what it's running at. So we'll see later when we do some gameplay in our video how smooth it is. Feedback, this is actually very important. This is if you run into any issues or bugs, definitely report them to the developer, because that's the easiest way for them to become aware of them and fix them. So if you click on this, it actually takes you to the forum, which I'll just show you super quick here. So you can see here, this is the forum, and there are a bunch of posts in there. You can see quite a few posts of people who have had issues and have reported them to hopefully get repaired. So again, if you're participating in the beta, the purpose of a beta isn't to get something earlier necessarily, it's to improve the experience for everyone when it gets released by reporting bugs. So that's important to do that. It's kind of our obligation if we download the beta. Settings. Same settings we looked at before, no need to revisit those. And about is telling you some stats, different rendering versions, what rendering engine it's using, and stuff like that. So like I said, nothing too crazy, nothing too exciting to us, but it's important to know for diagnostic purposes. So hopefully this video helped you out. This is a short, semi-short overview of what this emulator offers. And if this video did help you out or you learned something, definitely give it a thumbs up, because that helps grow the channel and helps grow the PUBG Mobile community. So if you're not subscribed, definitely consider doing that. There's a ton more PUBG Mobile content on the way, including some gameplay from this emulator, the new beta, some new loot locations to drop in, and a ton more, honestly. There's so many videos in the queue right now that it's exciting, and I hope that you join me for the journey. If you aren't a part of my Discord server, I'll leave a link to that below too. It's the easiest way to communicate with other members of the Derek G gaming community, as well as talk to me and set up games. So definitely check that out. And yeah, my name is Derek G, and I hope to see you on the battlefield soon or in the Discord.